Hello, my name is Miguel Morales. I'm the executive chef for Trinity Campus Dining. And today we're gonna be cooking green chicken enchiladas with homemade guacamole. We're gonna make a picante salsa from scratch. And also we have a salad with ranch dressing and chipotle ranch. So that will be the menu for today. I'm Miguel Morales, the executive chef for this campus. I guess some of you guys already know me, right? So today we're gonna be making guacamole from scratch, chips. We're gonna make picante sauce from scratch. We also gonna make rice and green chicken enchiladas. So this is a teaching cooking class. So if you guys wanna participate, you guys more than welcome. That's why I have two workstations. So really making guacamole from scratch is very simple. It's very easy. So I have cutting gloves so you don't cut yourself. I have different knives. So this is a paring knife, bone knife, and chef knife. This is a 9-inch chef knife. So we're basically not gonna be using these two knives. So I just had it just for you guys to see it. But I have a couple of chef knives that we can use. And also I have a few cutting gloves too. If you guys wanna help, I have some gloves. I have aprons, I have a chef hat. If you wanna wear chef hat, I'm prepared. So who wants to participate? And I'll show you what, it's very simple, don't be scared. This is the purpose of the class, and it's something that you guys can do while you're studying. And if you get hungry, you don't wanna cook like a heavy meal, you just wanna get something to snack on. You have a few avocados, you can just put it together and you got something to snack on. So again, just like you guys, I was learning at some point too. So don't worry about it. Nobody's perfect, all right? So anybody wants to start? No? Well, what you guys thinking, I'm actually gonna start boiling the chicken so we can get the chicken boiling. It's gonna take the most time. And then by then, you guys decide who's gonna help and who's not, all right? So the reason why I wanna get the chicken done first is because it's a raw product. Chicken has a lot of bacteria, especially salmonella. So we don't wanna, you know, have the chicken moving while we're making stuff that we're not gonna be cooking. So safety first. So now on this chicken, what we're gonna do is we're gonna boil that chicken with a little bit of salt and pepper. The salt is right here. And I got the pepper over here, just a little bit. And the right cooking temperature for chicken should be 165. And actually for any meats, 165 is the highest temperature for any kind of meat. And the reason why is because of salmonella. So you wanna make sure that if you're grilling chicken, cooking, boiling chicken, it's on 165. All right, so like I say, it was a raw product. All right, who's next? All right, so I have a cutting glove over here.
Do I need it?
Yeah, because okay. You're gonna be using a knife. Okay. And I want you to go home with you, oh. Five fingers. Yes, so safety first, okay? So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna wear the cutting glove on the hand where you're gonna hold the vegetable. So if you're gonna hold the knife with this hand, then the cutting glove should be on the hand, okay? So here's the avocados. Here's the jalapeno. We're gonna use onions, peppers, and a little bit of cilantro. All right, so we have all the vegetables together in here. So then you need another, on top of the cutting glove so you don't contaminate the food. All right, see, I even have mine. Don't feel bad. So I get my There you go. So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna hold the avocado, and then you're gonna cut it in half, and then we're gonna open. All right, okay. So hold it. Just kind of like go around, and then you open it, all right? Be careful, the knife is a little sharp. So while you're doing that, I'm gonna get everything together for homemade picante sauce. There you go, really good. And it's kind of like move the knife while it's inside of the avocado, and it should split the avocado. No? And the thickest part? We'll split it in a minute. There you go. So that's the last one. So for picante sauce, what we're gonna need, it's kind of like maybe half a cup of jalapenos, and this should be equal, diced tomatoes and crushed tomatoes, and obviously some diced onions. So when she's doing that, all right, so now you're gonna scoop the avocado out. So with a spoon, you just kind of like peel the skin off and then just put it in there, all right? So I'm gonna have to do some diced onions for my salsa. Gonna put in a pot. How you doing over there?
Good.
Okay, good. It's not really that hot, right?
Hot.
I say it's really hard.
No.
No? Good. All right. Good. You can just put it in the bowl with the bone, and then you can take the bone out once the skin is off too. So that'll be a little easier. So now I'm gonna chop the jalapenos too. Remember, when you're cutting vegetables, you're holding the knife almost to the very back, and then the knife never should move away from the cutting board. The tip of the knife is always have to stay on the cutting board, and you're just lifting and going down. And obviously, when you're holding the vegetable, you're just having your fingers kind of like inside. So this bone of you, this finger is gonna hold the knife from cutting you. So. Got it? All right. So now we're gonna do some diced onions. And now when you're doing a raw, anything raw, you really don't wanna use white onions. I think red onions is better because it's not as strong as the white onion, and it has better flavor for raw product. That's why we normally have it on sandwiches and stuff like that. So we're gonna dice it. The trash can is right next to you if you wanna throw that away. So you can keep your table organized. All right, so finished cutting my peppers here. So now let me change my gloves so I don't have those peppers. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna dice tomatoes. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna hold the tomato. You're gonna make the slices first. All right, you make the slices, and then you can get one or two at the same time, it's up to you. And then, okay, that's how you're gonna do the dice.
Okay.
All right? And then you just kinda like turn it, and same way. And then once you get the tomato dice, you add it to your bowl, all right? So again, once she's doing that, I'm gonna start cooking the onions. Once the onions and the jalapenos, they like saute and soft, then we'll add the crushed peppers and the diced tomatoes, We let it cook. We add salt, pepper, a little bit of garlic, and cumin, and that should be it for your picante sauce. So you add a little oil, and the only way you're gonna know if your onion is ready, it's gonna look like a, kinda like a clear white color. That's how you know your onion is done. Once it gets done and it's out there, then we add the rest of the items. So picante sauce is very basic, very cheap, and very easy to make. So once again, when you study and you don't have time to go to the store or just wanna leave home, that's something you can do. You can always keep 2 liter cans of diced tomatoes and crushed tomatoes. It's like, what, 59 cents per can, 60 cents. So that's something that's really cheap and it's good and it's a homemade, you know what you're doing, so you don't have to buy it. All right, so while it's cooking, I'll get my ingredients. How we done on the guacamole? And here I have maybe like 4 cups of each diced tomatoes and crushed tomatoes. Again, I mean, we're making a little, I was planning to make a little more, but since not everybody's here, so we make a little less. So I might just make like 2 cups of each. And then once it gets done, we'll chill it. So, doing okay? All right, good. So now I'm gonna let that boil, let the tomatoes cook. Cut the ends of the onion, then cut it in half. And we're probably gonna need only like half of this onion. So what we're gonna do, just hold it. Okay, cut it sideways. All right. And then to the side. So you'll get some equal size of the onion. And that's probably what we're gonna need. All right, and we'll put it in there. So now, that's basically it for your guacamole besides that cilantro. So in the cilantro, you're gonna chop, grab a bunch. Maybe like this much. And then you're gonna chop it. So just get like the whole bunch, and remember, the knife will never leave the cutting board, and you just lift it and chop it. All right, try it, let's see. And all we need for the guacamole will be salt. Can you pass me? Oh, I got it over here. All right. There you go. That's good. All right, so somebody wants to fry the chips? I got the chips already cut, the tortillas already cut, so somebody wants to help on that? You wanna help? All right, so the fryer is already on. I mean, I'm doing the chips because we actually have a fryer and everything, but if you guys wanna get the chips from the store, that'll be up to you guys. Let me show you. So you put the baskets in here. All right, we're gonna put a bunch. Don't put too many, so they don't cook even. And then you're just gonna dump it. Once you dump it, you stir it a little bit. So they all get cooked. And then once they get like a golden brown, that's how you know that the chips are already cooked. And then that salt. Once you get it that color, then you put it on this bowl. All right? You okay over there? All right, good. So once it starts bubbling a little less, then that's another sign that your chips is already done. Okay, so now I'm gonna add a little bit of salt to the guacamole. And then we're gonna smash the avocados with a spoon. So just gotta make sure that all the avocados get smashed and mixed with the other vegetables. And guacamole is done. So that's what, maybe 5-6 steps, and that's it. Can you pass me that dish so we can put the guacamole, please? Yeah, that one is fine. Just one. All right, put it in the bowl. And see, that was very simple. What, 5-10 minutes, guacamole. It didn't take that long, and it's a fresh product, and you're not gonna spend but probably maybe $5 to make that much. So, again. All right, so we'll put it away, so whenever we get to eat, it'll be ready. You might wanna pull the chips already. Should be done, yeah. So now, let's finish the salsa. I just need the salt, a little bit of garlic, and that should be it. So for picante sauce, we just add a pinch of garlic and a little bit of salt. Now on the salsa, it's up to you guys. You can add cumin, you can add a little bit of lime juice, a little bit of vinegar to make it kind of like a sour. You can add oregano to make it kind of like, give it a little flavor, different flavors. So there's a lot of things you can do with this salsa. Since it's a homemade, this is just basically the base and the basic salsa. So just gonna lower the heat a little bit, and then we should be able to pull it. Now, we're probably gonna need a little more. All right, so make sure you start this. Taste it, make sure it's got enough salt in there. Perfect. So homemade picante sauce is done. We're gonna put it in the other dish. So now, since the salsa has to be cold, we're gonna put it in this dish, and then we'll put it in the cooler just to chill. And then once it's chilled, then it should be ready for us to eat too. So let me put it in the cooler. So now the sauce is chilling. While the sauce is in there, the chicken is boiling. He's finished, almost finished frying the chips. So now we gotta make the green tomatillo sauce. So I have the tomatillos already cut. All we have to do that one is very simple too. I mean, you can buy like a pound of tomatillo and it's gonna give you enough for like maybe 8 to 10 enchiladas. Should be like nice and saucy. So for that, the only thing we need is basically the green tomatillos, a little bit of cilantro, and white onions. We're gonna blend it, and then we're gonna cook the tomatoes. So a little bit of oil, we're gonna saute some onions, julienne onions, and then we'll add the sauce in there. I mean, the whatever we blend, we'll put it in there, and 5-10 minutes your sauce is done. So again, overall, this meal should take you, I will say, no longer than 35 minutes. And again, it's really one of the cheapest items that you can get, and it's gonna be really good, really good. So, all right, so let me get some gloves so we can start blending the tomatoes. So there's that much tomatoes, like small bunch of cilantro, and maybe like a couple slices of onions. And a little bit of water so it won't be so dry for the blender. So once it's blent, we'll put it in the pot so we can get ready to cook it. So we're gonna do this twice since we gotta make a little more. Normally, if you're just making it again for yourself and somebody else, maybe 3 people, that's all you need. But since we're making it for a little more, then we'll make it twice. And some onions. A bit of water. Come on. All right, so basically this is gonna give us like maybe like half a gallon of the salsa. So now we gotta julienne some onions, some white onions. Excuse me. So if somebody asks you to julienne onions, julienne is what we normally use or know as a fajita cut, which you cut the onion. Then you peel it, and then you cut it from the side. So that's basically julienne onions. Same thing with bell peppers, so anything that you're gonna julienne is basically this cut. So dice, we normally do small dice, which that's what we did for the guacamole. We do like a 1/4-inch dice, which that's normally what we use for vegetables, like squash, zucchinis, even peppers when you're gonna saute all those vegetables together. So each cut has got different name. So these julienne onions, that's what we're gonna use for the sauce. Are you finished with the chips? All right. All right, so I get the pot and then we'll start frying the onions. Then we add the sauce and just a little bit of salt and that should be ready too. What was the proper temperature for chicken? 165, there you go. So, it's very close to be ready. So what if I wanna cook a piece of steak? Okay, so red meats, like when you go to the restaurant and you order like rare, it's actually 135, from 125 to 135, which it's kind of like the borderline to be edible. When you order medium well, it's kind of like 135 to 145. When you order well done, you pretty much killing the meat. But anyway, they'll cook it from probably 150 to 160, which is, to me, is really dry, and you're really wasting a piece of steak. But if you really wanna have, like, kinda like in between, that is gonna give you good flavor, it's not gonna be so dry, and it's gonna be tasteful, I will say 145, no higher than that. Unless if it's somebody who doesn't like any pink, then you cook it up to 160, which, that defeats the purpose, but oh well. All right, so pork, it'll be, should be 155. Chicken should be 165. And again, meats, depends. Fish, you can cook it on 145 too. Any kind of salmon, tilapia, any kind of fish, 145 is safe and it's not so dry. And the reason why I'm saying this is because when you overcooking anything, once it's not gonna taste good, it's gonna be dry, and you're just wasting your time cooking something. So when you're cooking at the right temperature, again, you're gonna get better flavor, it's gonna be nice and juicy, and everybody's gonna be happy. So chicken is almost done, so now we're gonna cook the sauce. Gonna add the onions in there. Then we're gonna dice the, we're gonna saute the onions. Just a little bit of oil. So now on the chicken, I normally save the juice. If you wanna make like chicken noodle soup, if you wanna make rice, anything that you comes to your mind, it's okay to save it. If you don't have anything to save it for, then just throw them away. But most of the time, I save it, because after I make something like that, I'm in the mood to make chicken noodle soup or stuff like that. So that's the best thing to do with that juice. So we're gonna saute the onions, we'll make the sauce, and then in the meantime, we're gonna pull the chicken for the chicken enchiladas. So really, when the chicken is really hot, it's really hard to pull the chicken or shred the chicken. But if you get like two forks, kind of like against each other, you're pulling the chicken really fast without burning your fingers, which that's what we're gonna do in a minute. So now the onions were soft, we add in this tomatillo in there. Once again, a little bit of salt. And a little bit of garlic. And that's it. So now we let that cook. Meantime, I can bring the pot. So we'll move these to now. So we'll get the flavor of the onion. We'll flip it. So we'll get the chicken, and then we're gonna pull the chicken, kind of shred it to stuff the enchiladas with. So chicken is nice and hot. You're not burning your fingers. Just kind of like a peeling, I don't know, an onion or something, and it's just like pulling the chicken. Does anybody want to try? You want to try it? Good. Try it. So we're gonna place the chicken in here. There you go. Anybody else wants to try it? We got another cutting board over here. You try it? All right, good. And I have two more forks over here. Yeah, you can put it in there. And then we can move the pot in between. All right. Good. If you want to wear gloves and you can get it with your hand, that's fine. So now while they pull in the chicken, we're going to get the tortillas ready. So now, most of the times people fry the tortillas a little bit to make it softer. I'm a little healthier, so I don't like to use a lot of oil if I can. So if you're at home, you can put it in the side of the bag, like plastic bag, and put it in the microwave for maybe about a minute. And they also get hard and soft. And then you can start making enchiladas without using a lot of oil. Again, it's up to you. I hear a lot of comments of people saying, oh, Mexican food is really greasy. Well, it's really greasy because it gets to the convenience areas where it's easy to do that and just pop it in the microwave and making it for everybody. So that's why they prefer to dip it in the oil for like 10 or 20 enchiladas at a time, and that's much easier. But again, if you're making it at home or your dorms or places like that, and you only have to make 4 or 6 enchiladas, you can easily put it in the microwave or you can heat it up on the stove. So that'll be not much oil. So it'll be way less oil than just dump it on the grease. All right, so today we're gonna go for the greasy part. Sorry, because we have no microwave, so, you know. Put it right here. So we're gonna dip it in the oil for a little bit, not too long, just enough to for the tortilla to get wet. And then the other side. All right. And then you drain most of the oil that you can. And then we're doing the same thing. Can you move to this side so they can see? All right. So just kind of like fan it up. Just put in the oil for maybe like less than a minute. Dip it, I mean, take it off, all the oil, shake it off. Shake all the oil out, and that's it. So, I don't know, I'm forecasting 2 enchiladas per person, 3. Is that okay? 3 enchiladas? Yes? No, maybe? 3? Yeah, they're working over there, so she's like, yeah, I want 3. That's good. So, maybe a little more, a few more, so 24. So we're gonna do the whole pack, which is 24. And then we'll go from there. All right. So now we have enchiladas. So once again, imagine this is not fried on that oil. So this is how soft the tortilla is gonna get if you put it in the microwave. Really, what you're doing when you put it in the back, you're steaming the tortilla to get soft. Because if you don't, when you're trying to roll the tortilla, it's gonna break. So you kind of like getting it warm to roll it so it won't break. The oil, that's what basically does too, because the oil is hot. So again, if you wanna go a little healthier, again, if you notice, we're not using a lot of grease. We're not using a lot of oil. The chicken is boiled, which is just mainly water. The guacamole is fresh. Again, no oil besides what's on the avocado. Enchiladas, they won't have a lot of oil besides what's in here. The salsa, it's very minimum oil. So again, Mexican food is really not that greasy as long as you know what you're doing. And that's what it is. All right, so we're gonna start rolling the enchiladas here. Are we almost done?
No? There's like 1 or 2 more.
Yeah, just a few more.
Yeah.
All right. So what we're gonna do is, let me put all the chicken together and see how much we have. All right. Yeah, if you wanna finish the chicken. So, excuse me. Sorry. So I have the cheese blend to make the enchiladas. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna mix the chicken with a little bit of cheese, a little bit of salt. We're gonna stuff the enchiladas. Then we'll put the sauce over, and then we'll put it in the oven to melt the cheese. Again, if you're doing it at home and you're doing it, you can do it by plate, and you can do exactly the same thing. You can put it in the plate, and once your plate is done, you put the sauce, and then you put the cheese, and then you put it in the microwave to melt the cheese. It's gonna be very hot once you pull it out of the microwave, but the cheese also melts, and it's just the same thing as if you put it in the oven. Now, if you're making it for your family, and you have a like big dish, like a clear dish, that you can put in the oven, that's the same thing. You do exactly the same thing. All you're doing is just kind of play with the quantities, all right? And then if somebody doesn't eat meat, you can make some cheese enchiladas for them, and everybody's happy. Right, so you eat chicken, they eat cheese. And that's why sometimes I don't like to use the broth for the sauce, because you never know, somebody might be vegetarian and, oh, there you got chicken on the sauce. Well, then what you gonna do? So, all right. And I think this should be enough. Yeah, whatever she's got and whatever you have, that should be enough. Just one more?
Yeah.
All right. Man, we're gonna make some fat enchiladas. So we're adding a little cheese. We're gonna mix it. Sorry, I don't mean to give you my. All right, so I'm gonna pull the pin so we can start rolling the enchiladas in here. Just let me put it in here, that should be it. So you wanna place the chicken in here? Oh yeah, sorry. All right, so does anybody want to roll enchiladas? It's very easy. You want to do that? All right, good. So let's roll enchiladas like grandma used to do. Excuse me. Okay, so anybody else wants to help?
No.
You, all right, good. All right, so you can get a bundle and you can get another bundle. All right, and this is what we're gonna do. You put a bunch, just like a pinch of this at the very beginning, and then you roll it. All right, just like that, just making a taco. All right, and then you place it in here. All right. So when you put it in here, make sure you put it like that, so we can put another roll in here and then we'll put it. All right. There you go. That should be enough. Yeah. All right, so let me check on the sauce. Okay, so now remember when you put enchilada in there, make sure the folding part it's on there. So when you do the enchilada, just kind of like this. If it, okay, like this, then roll it, and then this should be touching the bottom. So the weight of the enchilada will hold the enchilada from that. And you can leave a little room so the sauce will get to everywhere. All right. There you go. Nice. All right, so the sauce is done. We roll in the enchiladas. So once they leave me a little space in here, I'll chop the onions to do the rice, the white rice. It should take us another 10 minutes and then we should be done. While we place the enchiladas in the oven to melt the cheese, we'll make the rice, all right? Nice. All right, so let me get the sauce. All right, so the enchiladas they roll. Excuse me, this is really hot. Let me get this away. There you go. So now the enchiladas, they roll in there in the pan. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put the sauce all over. Make sure there's sauce everywhere. All right. And then cheese on top. So now we'll put it in the oven for like maybe anywhere from 7 to 10 minutes to melt the cheese and get golden brown, and then it should be it, all right? Alright, so now the enchiladas are cooking. So then I'm gonna dice a little onions for the rice. For the rice. So we're gonna place some of the onions in here. Get that much. And some of that rice. Again, I was planning to make enough rice for like 20 people, but we don't have 20 people, obviously, so maybe 1 or 2 cups of rice. And that should be enough for us. All right. And we're gonna fry it. So we'll fry the rice for like maybe 5-6 minutes. And once it's fried, we're just gonna add a little chicken base. Again, if you don't eat meat and you wanna make vegetarian, you can just add a little vegetable base. If not, you can just put a little water and maybe some spices just to give it the flavor. But this time I'm making the rice with a little chicken base. And actually, this is the kind of rice that my mom used to make when I was little. So, really, it was not the typical red rice that you'll see everywhere. It was always this with mole and chicken. That was perfect. It was really good. So, there's not very many places where you're gonna see this kind of rice. Actually, been cooking almost all over the US, and there's only been one place where I had this rice. Only one place out of I don't know how many restaurants I ever tried. And that was like really surprising. It was really good. It was very tasty. So when the rice is fried, we're gonna make the mix for the rice chicken base. So we're gonna put maybe like 1/2 cup. And then water. And it's gonna be kind of like a yellowish color on the rice, not so white, but again, it's really good. So once the rice is fried, alright, we'll add the... Now the key of the rice, so it won't get kind of like look smashy, it's that once you put the water in there, you're not supposed to move the rice that much. So that way it'll get kind of like sticky, kind of like a rice pudding, more than just the rice. So if you keep stirring it while it's boiling, then that's what's gonna happen. It's gonna get kind of like smashy. You let it boil with the water. Now, if it needs a little more water and the rice is not, I mean, if the rice is not soft enough and you need to add a little more water, just put the water all over the rice and just kind of like move it a little bit with the spoon. But don't try to stir the whole rice because it's gonna make a mess. So yeah, let me check on the enchiladas. All right, it's getting there. So again, this is a very simple, easy menu, dinner. Again, everybody likes chicken, everybody likes rice. Well, personally, I do. And I love guacamole, especially fresh. I love picante salsa. And anytime I can make it at home, I'll just make it. I just don't like to buy it. And again, it's, I mean, something you can do while you're studying, while you getting ready to go to work, whatever you gotta do, it's simple, all right? So now, if you really wanna garnish your guacamole, it's very simple. Just like a potato peeler, you can just take the skin off the tomato. Make sure the tomato is a little firm. All right, and then you just roll the skin. Sure it doesn't go anywhere. Right, and then I think we used to, can you pass me the cilantro, please? You can just get a few leaves of cilantro, just like a little bunch. Just place it in the corner, and then you can do your roast. It's very simple, and it's a little touch that you can put on anything. So, and it would take you one tomato in 5 minutes and a potato peeler, that's it. All right, so let's check on the rice. So we lower the flame a little bit so it won't get dry too fast, and we'll have to add more water. So we just wait. We're almost there, okay? We just got like a few more minutes and we should be done. All right. So how long we been in here? Roughly an hour. And we put a menu together for what, 6-7 people, 8 people. And everything is homemade. So again, we're making a little bigger quantity. You don't have to make that much. So that might take you less, maybe half of that time. So while the rice is cooking, we can set up the table. So the salsa's cold. So basically this is what you're looking for. When the salsa cools down a little bit. So now the salsa, I didn't think the jalapenos were gonna be that spicy because it's king jalapenos and normally they not. They got a little spicy. So be careful when you eat it. Can you take them outside, please? And then we have the chips. So on the chips, another tip is whenever they coming out of the fryer, if you wanna add a little salt, even lemon pepper, barbecue spice. I mean, you can do whatever you want with that. It's, again, that is just basically the base. So if you wanna do sopapillas, I don't know, who knows what it, you can easily make it with a flour tortilla. You'll cut it, you'll fry it, and then you have your cinnamon and sugar mix. Once it comes out of the fryer or the oil, you put it in a bowl and then you add the mix and then toast it and it's done. It's very simple. And actually, if you wanna go the extra mile, there's some parts where they sell the tortilla dough that is raw, it's not cooked. You can do the same thing. Just, that's what we call viñuelos. The raw tortilla and then we'll fry it and then we put cinnamon and sugar and a little bit of honey and it's like a tostada. So. Yeah, yes. Well, that's what it is. It's basically the tortilla, but not in a pan, but fry. Actually, back in my days, when I came to the States, I worked for Taco Cabana. And Taco Cabana, that's the tortillas like that. So I didn't have anything else to do. And, you know, I was like thinking about my country and I'm like, yeah, raw tortilla. So I got grind and then I drop it on the oil. And then my boss was around and he's like, what are you doing? I'm making viñuelos. He's like, what is that? I said, just try it. So he tried it. And then after that, we started selling it at the restaurant too, because they were really tasteful. And then after that, it was all over Taco Cabana for maybe, they selling it for like 2 years and then they take them off because they start selling some other stuff. So they refreshed the menu for the most part, but that's actually how it started. And it's, I mean, again, it's really simple, easy thing to do, and it's really good. So right before the rice is gonna be done, this is another extra touch that you can put in there for flavor, peas. Some people do the peas and carrots. I don't like, I think diced carrots is for like babies. I don't know. So I just don't like diced carrots. I like peas. And also, I mean, carrots don't give a lot of flavor, but peas does. So just right before the rice is gonna be done, we'll add that in there because this is don't need to be cooked. And obviously if you add it in there way too early, they're gonna get smashed. So you don't want that either. Oof, just in time. Let me get the, oh yeah, right here. Oops. So now we have enchiladas, and then we'll just wait for the rice. I got some sour cream in there, so if you wanna put the sour cream out there too, please. So we're gonna have a good meal. I hate to say that, but that's the truth. So, is anybody haven't have that before? You do? I know sometimes we have it over here in the CAF, on the International. Really? Where was it?
In Michigan.
Here? In Michigan? Yeah. You're from Michigan?
Yeah.
What part?
Like a little bit north of Detroit.
Really? You're just a little far.
Yeah.
right. So, should be a few minutes on the rice. So our table should be set up already. There's some plates. There's the salad. Also with the salad, I have queso fresco. Well, basically the salad, it's just a basic lettuce salad mix with corned bean and roasted corn. And it's got tomato, cilantro, a few spices. And then the chipotle dressing, chipotle ranch, regular ranch, and also the queso fresco. I love queso fresco, especially in the enchiladas. Basically, if that'll be my choice, that'll make it at home. It'll be queso fresco instead of melting cheese. But I don't know if you guys really like that kind of cheese, so I just, yeah. But there's some outside. If you want to put on top of your enchiladas, you're more than welcome. All right? Trinity is a really good school. I mean, again, I've been all over the place, and I love this place. I mean, it's close to home. I grew up in Austin. So, again, you know, I've been moving all over the places, and I was really looking to get back home. Basically, Texas is home for me, or Austin. And when this job became open, I was like, yay! San Antonio, yes! And that'll be ready for service. Two things I love as far as Mexican food is stuffed peppers and enchiladas. I mean, that's my favorite thing to eat. And also milanesas. So milanesa is kind of like a chicken fried steak, but we use a little thin meat that is a little softer, and then we'll bread it with panko or breadcrumbs and fry it, and it's really good. Yeah. Especially if you make a little tomatillo sauce and some rice and beans and, ooh, yeah. All right, let's check on the rice. It should be ready. All right, so rice is ready as well. So this is what we call in a Spanish Mexican rice or Spanish rice. So that's, again, that's how we used to make it back home. I mean, we also make the other one, don't get me wrong, but this, especially with mole, it's really good. So all right, let's put it out there and then we can start eating.
Thanks. It's good to wake you.